let's move forward. Matt, your next case this evening is VA-2018-15, Tichon?
Yes, sir. This is a rezoning request to rezone two properties that total 1.79 acres from R-10 to RM for the purpose of a developing a proposed multifamily apartment complex that consists of 32 apartments. Some of you may recall two different requests that we had back in 2014. One was the character area map amendment for the adjacent hotel. It's on the zoning map. You see it's CC zoning. That is the island across the street. That is a four-story extended hotel that is currently operating. Character area change was to go from transitional neighborhood to community activity center. So that's been updated on the maps. Aerial image shows what was once a semi-rural neighborhood in County Island many years ago. It was annexed in. Many of the residential properties used to be owner-occupied, however, most all of them are renter-occupied. Within the past 10 years, there has been the development of an apartment complex in the back of the neighborhood, condos by the Lowndes, so those were referred to as Harmon Heights. You see that there in the aerial image. As we talked about during the character area change a few years ago, the general plan for this neighborhood has shifted to that of more intensity. R-10 zoning is not intensive enough for the character area, so the land use policy really calls for higher density residential or even light commercial or offices. The question really is to try and facilitate an orderly transition, and that's really staff's main concern. The applicant is proposing two of the lots to transform that are one lot away from the existing apartments. They may have plans to eventually expand that into other redevelopment properties. The applicant currently owns these properties as rental housing. In your packet, you see the survey of the two existing homes with the lots, also two different site plans, two different versions of the same 32-unit complex. One is a two-story version, like you see here. This one is very similar, but it's a three-story version. The benefits of this one, like we talked about at the work session, less building footprint, same number of parking, but more green space and open space and more flexibility in the design. Some examples of building elevations. This is not necessarily what the applicant is planning to use architecturally, but just to give some ideas of what a two-story or three-story apartment building may look like. The applicant is here along with their engineer. You saw an email exchange earlier today. There was one neighbor across the street. He was concerned about the design of the apartments, not so much the use, but how they're going to look. So you've got those comments. I gave you a handout of that, hard copy this afternoon. And then you, I believe, should have gotten an email response also from the applicant about that email. Some other examples, but first, some photographs, subject property, two existing homes. This is looking towards San Augustine Road. Some of the houses nearby, this is one of the existing homes. The other one. This is the four-story hotel. This is as seen from the corner of the subject property, looking diagonally across the street at the hotel. So as you can see, the neighborhood has already started to change somewhat. This is the house that is across the street from the hotel and next to the subject property. This is the property that is owned by the gentleman who sent you the email this morning. This is the house next door to that. This is a mobile home park that is directly behind the subject property facing Harmon Drive. And this is the apartment complex up at the end. This is the main entrance. And then some interior shots of the buildings within the complex. And then as examples, since we've been talking a little bit through email about architecture, I put in a random sampling of some existing apartment complexes in Valdosta. This is Blanton Common, which is just down the street from here. This is the Lynx Apartments on North Valdosta Road. This is the apartment complex on Murray Road, which has changed names. I think it was called University Courtyard. I'm not sure what it's called now. And then the Timbers, which is on West Cranford. It's not too far from BSU. But just some ideas of different styles of architecture that we've seen in apartments in Valdosta the past few years. Quite a variety. So the request is that of a zoning change based on two different site plans that are very similar
like with a two-story plan that with the four different buildings. I'm just curious, and I don't know if this, won't know if the engineering actually gets involved, but the fire department have any contention with the radius, the short radius on the four units that have to turn in?
They did not. And just from their applicant's engineers here to address that. And it meets all the development standards here in terms of buffer yards and so forth. But no comments from the fire department about that horseshoe turn. It's not quite 180 degrees.
And a three-story would meet all height requirements?
You would increase the setback a few feet, which is what they're showing here. Buffer yard really is what takes over, because you have the buffer yard itself. If they put a fence, they get a reduction in the buffer yard, but there's a 5-foot separation between the buildings and the buffer yard. And all of that is reflected on these site plans.
Commissioners, any questions for staff?
Mr. Chairman.
The U-turn down there, what is the width of that? How much space is it to make that turn?
It looks like 40 feet, as I eyeball it. The main part of the aisle is 24 feet, and it looks like a little more than 1.5 that by my eye, so I'm guessing 40.
You talking about on the three-story, Commissioner Willis?
And that's something they would have to comply with as part of
the two-story.
So, but with the three-story, I'm not sure if the ladder covers
I can't hear you in the back.
I'll let their engineer address that one. But again, these are conceptual site plans. These are not engineered, approved, drawn by the city. Just simply a cursory review.
Okay. Mr. Willis, any other questions for staff? There being none, anyone here this evening wishing to speak in favor of this request to come forward this time? Anyone wishing to speak in favor of this request? Good evening, sir.
Good evening. My name is Matt Phelps. I'm the engineer for the project. My address is 4560 F. Mr. Mark did a good job introducing and explaining this all. A couple questions I'll probably ask real quick. I did not deal with turning radius check on that for the ladder truck for the fire department. That is something I'll discuss with them if need be, to make sure either the turning radius suits their needs or there is a certain distance they'll pull in and then just back out if need be. They do allow that. Yeah, I think it's 200 feet over. So more than likely that site plan would meet their requirements. Obviously, if changes need to be made, we'll make it. But if y'all have any other questions or concerns?
You're going to go ahead and include it on the privacy fence?
Yes. To reduce the buffer yards.
Right.
That will be included. It's a 6-foot minimum height.
That's right. Commissioners, any questions for presenter?
Well, I just want to make sure all we're approving or not approving here is just the rezoning of the property,
that's
not
correct.
The site plan.
That's
right.
Correct.
Okay.
This was just to illustrate what could fit, physically fit on the
right.
A couple of different options.
And one obvious change to it, you can imagine that if you put the buildings in the middle and the parking on the outside, that's certainly a flip side of the coin option. They were trying to show this as the buildings face each other rather than face out. And it seems to fit.
Any other questions for our presenters? Matt, thank you very much. Anyone else here this evening wishing to speak in favor of this request? Anyone else wishing to speak in favor of this request? There being none, anyone here this evening wishing to speak against this request? Anyone wishing to speak against this request? There being none, we close this part of the meeting. Commissioners, any questions? Any thoughts going forward on this? There being none, I will take a motion on this request this evening.
Mr. Chairman, I make a motion that we accept VA-2018-15 as presented.
We have a motion. Do I have a second?
Yes, I have a second motion.
We have a second. Okay, so we have a motion and a second to approve our case this evening. Any discussion on that before I ask for a vote? There being none, all in favor of the motion, please signify by raising your right hand. Ms. Carmella, that is once again unanimous. Mr. Mark, you're doing a really good job this evening, sir.